Hello student, welcome to the chemistry class. Today we discuss part 3 of chapter 1, standard 10 science. Now in this lecture we discuss displacement reaction first. So what is displacement reaction? So I will explain you by taking one general equation, that if we have AX plus B and if it gives A plus BX. So see here, the place of A is displaced by B. Okay, here B replaces the position of A. So this type of chemical reaction is known as displacement reaction. Let we discuss by taking an example of this reaction. Okay, so in this experiment we take three nails. Here all the nails are cleaned by rubbing with sandpaper. Why it is necessary? It is necessary due to there is an oxide layer which is formed on iron, is removed when we rub this iron nail with sandpaper. So to remove the oxide layer of iron, we use sandpaper. Okay, we rub this iron nail with the sandpaper. Now take two test tube, mark as A and B. In each test tube take 10 ml of copper sulfate solution. Okay, the color of copper solution, copper sulfate solution is blue. Now tie two iron nails with a thread and immerse them carefully in the copper sulfate solution. Okay, see here, we put iron nail inside the copper sulfate solution. Now keep one iron nails aside. Okay, now after 20 minutes take out the iron nails from the solution. Now check the intensity of blue color. It is lighter compared to initial stage, means when we start the experiment the color of copper sulfate is very dark, but after 20 minutes when we place the iron nail inside the solution, the color of copper sulfate solution become light. So why this happens? What chemical reaction occurs in this? So see, the change of copper sulfate solution after placing iron nails inside it, it become light. Okay, and also the color of iron nail also become brown, brownish color. Initially it is shining, having shining surface, but after the experiment the color of the iron nails are brown. So why iron nails become brown? So there is a replacement reaction. Okay, replacement reaction are happens where Fe replace copper inside the solution. So it can be explained by this chemical reaction. Initially we have pure Fe. Okay, now when we put Fe inside the copper sulfate solution, here B is our copper and sulfate is X. Okay, so displacement reaction take place. The position of B are taken by A, that is Fe, and it become AX, that is what is A, it is our Fe, and X is SO4. So it become FeSO4 plus copper, that is B, is become free. Okay, so A plus BX gives AX plus B. this type of reaction is happened in this experiment. Iron replaces the another element, that is copper, from the copper sulfate solution. This reaction is known as displacement reaction. Another displacement reaction is zinc, which is our A, replace the copper from copper sulfate solution and form zinc sulfate, and copper become free. Same way, lead when put in solution of copper chloride, it form lead chloride, and copper are free from the solution. Why this reaction is happened? Because zinc and lead are more reactive elements than copper. They displace copper from its compound. Okay, another example means, how can we find that which element can replace another element? So there is a electrochemical reaction series in which first it is potassium, then sodium, then calcium, then magnesium, aluminium, zinc, Fe means iron, Pb, lead, then hydrogen, then copper, Hg, mercury, Ag, silver, and Au, gold. So it is a reactivity series. So if you have a solution of sodium chloride, so from sodium chloride NaCl, which element can replace sodium? So the element which come first left to that element, so potassium. So potassium can replace sodium, but calcium Ca cannot replace sodium. So remember here ki jo bhi element ka solution hai, yahan hamara example tha FeSO4. Okay, so FeSO4 yahan aata hai. तो Fe को कौन रिप्लेस कर सकता है, सॉरी कॉपर, CuSO4 सॉल्यूशन है, तो कॉपर को कौन रिप्लेस कर सकता है? तो जो भी उसके लेफ्ट है, लेफ्ट कौन है? हाइड्रोजन. कौन कौन रिप्लेस कर सकता है? तो हाइड्रोजन, लेड, Fe, जिंक, एल्यूमिनियम, मैग्नीशियम, ये सब कॉपर को रिप्लेस कर सकते हैं, ये सब डिस्प्लेसमेंट रिएक्शन दे सकते हैं. लेकिन जो सिल्वर, गोल्ड और मर्क्यूरी हैं, गोल्ड, सिल्वर और मर्क्यूरी, दे कैन नॉट रिप्लेस कॉपर फ्रॉम इट्स सॉल्यूशन. द रिएक्शन रिमेन एज इट इज. ओके, सो रिमेंबर दिस इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल सीरीज. फ्रॉम दिस अ क्वेश्चन मे बी आस्क दैट विच एलिमेंट कैन रिप्लेस अनदर एलिमेंट. ओके, सो हाइएस्ट रिएक्टिव एलिमेंट इज पोटेशियम एंड लोएस्ट रिएक्टिव एलिमेंट इज गोल्ड. ओके, सो रिमेंबर दिस थिंग्स. Our second type of reaction is double displacement reaction. So what is double displacement reaction? So it is AX plus BY gives, sorry, one minute. Here, AX plus BY gives A replace B and B replace A, so we get A with Y means AY plus BX. This type of reaction is known as double displacement reaction, in which one element replace another. Okay, here two single displacement reaction occurs, means A replace B, that is single displacement, while B replace A, that is another displacement. That's why it is known as double displacement reaction. Remember this general equation. Okay, it is important that to remember double displacement reaction. So let perform one activity. We take sodium sulfate solution in test tube, okay, one test tube. In another test tube we take barium chloride, okay. In one test tube we have sodium sulfate, that is Na2SO4, while another we have barium chloride, that is BaCl2. So when we mix, our A is Na2SO4, okay, X is Na2, X is SO4, our B is Ba and Y is Cl. So what happened? AX means Na and SO4. We know how many form bond can sulfate form? 2. How many bond Na form? 1. So here multiply by 2, means here 2 comes there. So Na2SO4 plus okay BaCl2. How many bonds Ba form? 2. Cl 1. So here 2. So when these two mix, which product is formed? So Na with Cl. So NaCl. Na form one bond, Cl form one bond. So we have NaCl. Okay, NaCl. Now BaSO4. Ba form two bond, SO4 form two bond. So we get BaSO4. So our product is NaCl plus BaSO4. Now just balance. Here 2Cl, 1Cl. So multiply here by 2. Okay, so we get barium sulfate and sodium chloride as a double displacement product. Here which we get barium sulfate as solid product, while NaCl are dissolved in water, so it is aqueous in nature. Now there is one example given, that solution of lead nitrate, that is PbNO3 twice, okay, react with Ki plus Ki, which product is formed? So which product is formed? A is Pb, X is NO3, B is K and Y is I. So A and Y, that is Pb and I. So PbI, Pb make 2 bond, I make 1 bond, so PbI2, this is our first product, okay, plus Bx, Bx means KNO3, K make how many bonds? 1 bond, NO3 make 1 bond, so we get KNO3, but here 2Ki, because here 2I2 is there. Same way 2NO3 is there, so multiply here by 2. So what we get? PbI2 plus 2KNO3. Product of this reaction is PbI2 plus 2KNO3. Okay, this is our product of this reaction. Okay, so what is the answer? First, which color? So yellow, PbI2 is yellow, so yellow color is formed. What is the name of that compound? It is solid, it is aqueous, KNO3 is. So it is, what is the name? Lead iodide. Now write the balance equation, okay, just complete this. Now is this double displacement reaction? Yes, it is double displacement reaction. Now oxidation and reduction reaction. So what is oxidation and what is reduction reaction? So oxidation reaction means we discuss this by taking a example. Here we heat copper powder in China dish, porcelain dish, we can say porcelain dish, okay. So see the assembly, burner is there, one tripod, wire gauge, China dish and copper powder is there, okay. So when we heat this mixture, it form copper oxide, that is copper. When heated, it form copper oxides, 2 Cu. When heated in presence of oxygen, it form CuO. Okay, so what is oxidation reaction? Oxidation reaction means if addition of oxygen take place in any reaction. Here see, oxygen molecule is added in copper, that's why it is known as oxidation reaction. So what is oxidation reaction? Addition of oxygen is oxidation reaction. Second, removal of hydrogen, removal of H2. If in any reaction hydrogen is removed, then it is known as oxidation reaction. So these two things you have to remember, that addition of oxygen, this is oxidation reaction. When in any reaction oxygen is added, then it is known as oxidation reaction. If oxygen is removed, then it is known as reduction reaction. See here, when copper oxide react with H2, what happen? Oxygen from copper oxide is removed, so this is known as reduction reaction. Okay, while see H2, in H2 oxygen is added, so for H2O it is oxidation reaction, while for CuO it is reduction reaction. While CuO is reduction reaction, because in CuO oxygen is removed, that's why it is reduction reaction. And here in hydrogen oxygen is added, first we have only hydrogen H2, but in product we have H2O, so it oxygen is added, that's why it is oxidation reaction. So remember, from CuO we get Cu, oxygen is removed, so it is reduction reaction. While in H2 oxygen is added, so this is oxidation reaction. Okay, when in some reaction there is oxidation and reduction take place simultaneously, mean in single reaction oxidation and reduction take place, such type of reaction is known as oxidation reduction reaction or redox reaction. Means agar koi reaction mein oxidation bhi hota hai aur reduction bhi hota hai, to us reaction ko redox reaction kehte hai. Okay, so ye jo reaction tha wo kaisa hai? Redox reaction, because oxidation bhi hota hai aur reduction bhi hota hai same reaction mein. Another example of redox reaction is here. Okay, जिंक है, तो इसमें किसका ऑक्सीडेशन और किसका रिडक्शन होता है? तो जिंक का जिंक, ZnO से जिंक हुआ, तो इसमें से ऑक्सीजन रिमूव हुआ, तो ये क्या हुआ? रेडॉक्स रिडक्शन रिएक्शन. कार्बन में ऑक्सीजन ऐड हुआ, सो ये क्या हुआ? ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन. ओके, सो ये ऑक्सी, ये रिडक्शन. ओके, सेम वे ये तुम्हारे लिए होमवर्क है कि MnO2 में 4HCl है, तो किसका ऑक्सीडेशन और किसका रिडक्शन? तो MnO2 में से MnCl2, तो इसमें ऑक्सीजन रिमूव हो गए, देखो, सो इट इज रिडक्शन रिएक्शन. HCl में से H2O हो गया, इसमें ऑक्सीजन ऐड हुआ, तो ये ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन. सो रिमेंबर, दिस टू is redox reaction, because oxidation and reduction take place simultaneously in single reaction. Okay, now if effect of oxidation and reduction reaction in everyday life. So first is corrosion. You must observe that iron articles are shiny when new, but get coated with reddish brown powder when left for some time. हमने देखा ही होगा कि आयरन, जब हम लोहे की चीज़ लाते हैं नहीं, तो वो शाइनिंग मारते हैं, लेकिन थोड़े टाइम बाद ड्यूरिंग द मेंस मॉनसून इट बिकम रेडिश ब्राउन, हम बोलते हैं काट लग गया. सो व्हाट इज दिस? सो इट इज़ अ रस्टिंग, मीन्स इट इज हैपन ड्यू टू oxidation of iron. So the change of color of iron, it become reddish brown from shiny. This process is known as rusting of iron. Some other metal also get tarnished in this manner. Have you noticed the color of coating forming copper and silver? Means we find that copper article become greenish. So it is also rusting of copper. Copper become green, Fe become reddish brown. Now silver, Ag. What happen in silver if it is rusted? So it become black. So Fe remember reddish brown, copper become green due to rusting, and silver become black. So why they rust? So rusting is happens due to presence of moisture, acid, etc. When moisture, okay, water contain attack to the any metals or acid, it become corrode, and this process is known as corrosion. The black coating on silver and green coating on copper are the example of corrosion. Means it is a corrosion. Corrosion causes damage to car body, bridge, iron railing, ships, and to all made of metals. Object, all the object that made up of metal are corrode due to rust, means due to attack of acid and moisture. Corrosion of iron is a serious problem. Every year an enormous amount of money is spent to replace damaged iron. We know if rusting is happen in iron railings or bridge, we have to replace them with new one. So it cost too many rupees. So corrosion cost many money, okay, to replace damaged iron. We discuss corrosion in chapter 3 in detail. Okay, now what is rancidity? So what is rancidity? Have you ever tasted smell and the fat or oil containing food materials left for long time? Means if you हमने अगर कुछ food और कोई oil लंबे समय तक रखा है ऐसे ही, तो किसी ने smell किया है, कैसे उसकी smell आती है? तो उसकी स्मेल बहुत ख़राब आती है. हम बोलते हैं कि वो फूड और ऑयल बिगड़ गया है. सो व्हाट इज़ दिस? सो द फैट एंड ऑयल आर ऑक्सीडाइज एंड दे बिकम रेंसिड हैविंग बैड स्मेल एंड ऑल्सो द टेस्ट ऑफ दैट थिंग्स आर चेंज. यूजुअली सब्सटेंस विच प्रिवेंट ऑक्सीडेशन आर एडेड टू फूड कंटेनिंग फैट्स एंड ऑयल. सो हम क्या करते हैं कि उसको अगर स्टोर करना है तो हम एंटी ऑक्सीडेंट डालते हैं. अगर हम कोई चीज़ बाहर से मंगवाते हैं फ्रोजन, तो उसमें क्या ऐड होता है? एंटीऑक्सीडेंट. वी कैन फाइंड दैट एंटीऑक्सीडेंट ऑन द लेबल ऑफ दैट फूड पैकेट. ओके, दैट विच एंटीऑक्सीडेंट्स आर एडेड. ऑल्सो द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग बैग, ओके, फॉर ऑफ बालाजी वेफर्स, लेज, दैट आर फिल्ड विथ सम गैस. सो दिस गैस इज नाइट्रोजन एंड इट विल हेल्प टू प्रिवेंट ऑक्सीडेशन ऑफ दैट फूड. अगर वो गैस नहीं फिलअप किया होता तो वो फूड क्या होता? बिगड़ जाता. दैट्स वाई द नाइट्रोजन गैस इज यूज टू प्रिवेंट रेंसिडिटी. ओके, so remember this. Okay, that's all for this unit. Solve this all question of exercise. Okay, thank you.